Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So guys, today we are going to learn about system state backup, means how to take system state backup. So first I want to explain about what is system state backup and how we can take system state backup. So first we'll see what is system state backup. So you can see system state backup. Backup operating system file, enabling you to recover when machine start, but you have lost system files and registry. A system state backup includes boot files, COM plus class registration database, and registry file. So guys, if you have missed your system operating files or any you have lost any system files or registry file or any boot files, so if you have a system state backup, then you can restore, you can just restore, and after restoring your system, or you can say your server will be up. So I hope you have now idea what is system state backup. So let us start now how we can take system state backup. So first we have to install feature, that is Windows Server Backup Utility tool. So this is Windows Server 2016. So we'll use tools option, and we'll use manage, add roles and feature, click to next, role based and feature based, dc.test.lang. This is my DC, means domain controller server, and these are the roles. So just click on next and try to install Windows backup utility, that is Windows Server Backup. So click next, Windows Server Backup. Restart the destination server automatically if required. So we are going to leave this as default. If required, it will ask to reboot this. Click to install. It will take some time. Yes, so guys, you can see installation succeeded on dc.test.lang, means feature has been installed successfully. This is the notification, installation succeeded on DC. Now go to tools. Windows Server Backup. So this is the console of Windows Server Backup, and it is getting ready. Here you can see backup schedule and backup once. So if you want to schedule so that backup will automatically backed up on the schedule time, but if you want to take backup a single time backup, so go to backup once option, difference, create a backup now using different option. If this is grayed out, schedule backup, because we have chosen backup once option, not backup scheduled option. So click next. Full, I want to backup all my server data, application and state backup, but we have to just take system state backup, means state backup. So we'll select custom, next. Add items. You can see here system state, click OK, go to next option, local folder, choose the type of storage for the backup. So if you want, you can take backup on any shared folder, on any server shared folder, or no, local drives. So here it is showing local drives, D example local disk, or DVD drive E. So we'll check here. Here local disk C, and this is the DVD. So I think you cannot take remote in C drive, because this is related to system state backup and system files. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to create one shared folder on another server, or if you have a local drive, or if you have external drive, USB external drive, so just you can connect external drive. You can take the state backup in the external drives, or if you have existing any other drives, then you can select this. But here I have only C drive and another one is DVD drive. So I am going to create one shared folder on the same network server, which is different server. So let me create one shared folder first. So I'm going to take a remote another server. This is test.lan is my domain. So I am going to create here one folder, or you can create on the desktop. I am going to create here on my desktop, but you can create on another drive for safe site. So DC state backup properties, sharing, advanced sharing, share this folder, permission. So here you can see everyone is selected by default with read only permission. So if you want, you can add your domain user. So I'm going to add here this user, select full control, everyone have only read control. If you want, you can remove, apply, okay, because this is backup and everyone should have not rights to access this. Now let us jump on this server, DC server, and try to access that server 10. Okay, so you can see here this is accessible here. So what we'll do, we'll just copy this path, minimize remote share folder. So guys, please take care. If you have not another disk except C, then you can select this option, remote shared folder. So I'm going to click next, and here I'm going to enter the folder, shared folder path, that is 10.10.10.10 and DC state backup. Access control, a folder name Windows image backup will be created inside the specified share to store the backup. Means in this folder, within this folder DC state backup, means in shared folder Windows image backup folder will be created. Here you can see access control, do not inherit. This option makes the backup accessible only for the user whose credentials are provided in the next step. Inherit, this option makes the backup accessible to everybody who has access to the specified remote shared folder. So generally as I have already provide access to the specific user, that is SKY. So in your case, if you have provide a specific shared folder access to the user, then you can select this, or otherwise if you want only for those the user whose credentials are provided in the next step, then you can select this option. So I have already shared folder and provide the specific rights to the user. So I am going to select this, click next, and backup. You can see creating shadow copy of volume. Backup location is this data transferred. Now it's started state backup, 226 files found, 1.92 MB, 317. Can see here in the shared folder backup is created, backup that is Windows image backup folder is created, and you can see DC. So it is still in progress. So guys, it will take some time. Till now I am going to pause video. Yes, so guys, you can see the backup has been successfully done now. So you can see backup and description is successful. I want to explain one more thing. Suppose if you are going to schedule state backup, or if you are going to take backup, state backup. So next, as we have already done this, so select this system state backup, click OK, and to go to advanced setting. Here you can see VSS setting, VSS copy backup and VSS full backup. So here it is by default select VSS copy backup. So you can see the VSS full backup is for it is saying choose this option if you are not using any other product to backup application. This option update the backup history of each file and clear the application log. And VSS copy backup, choose this option if you are using another product backup application that are on the volume includes in the backup. Means if you are using any other application for backup, then you have to select this VSS copy, otherwise select VSS full backup and click OK, and then click next, and the same and the rest is the same process which I already shown you. So just I'm going to cancel this. So guys, in this way you can take backup, system state backup, and one more option, that is command. So I can show you how you can take system state backup through command run as administrator. Yes, so here you have to enter command wbadmin space start system system state sorry backup and backup target if you want you can enter, and you can see the here example wbadmin start system start backup space hyphen backup target. So here we missed here hyphen backup target colon. If you have a drive like D drive, E drive, then select enter here E drive. Otherwise if you want to take backup on shared folder, so just enter here the network shared path like 10.10.10/dc/state/backup and hit enter. So once you will enter, then backup will be start, and in same way like here we have taken backup. DC DC state backup. So in the same way Windows image backup folder will be created, and under this DC backup catalog SPMS metadata cache and media LD. So in same way you can take backup through backup utility or the command line. So guys, I hope this will be helpful for you. So request you to please subscribe my channel for other videos and click on bell icon for notification. Thanks. Bye bye. If you have any query, please leave your comment. Thanks.